Hello everyone, in this lecture we will be discussing what are the physiological changes which is occurring in a woman's body while she is carrying two or more fetuses inside her womb and how we can confirm this pregnancy by various diagnostic features. Okay, so in previous part we already discussed what are the varieties and now we will discuss what are the changes which took place in a woman's body. So, although there are various changes which occur in a woman's body once she gets pregnant, but while carrying a two fetus inside her womb at the same time demands more. Okay, so let's see what are the changes. Firstly, if we talk about the weight, as in normal, weight is increases, but here also weight is increases, but in comparison to that, it is more higher. Why? Because there are the two fetus, the weight of the uterus is more, the fluid is collected inside, the extracellular spaces is more, the woman is in hypervolemic state because there is a demand for the two fetuses at the same time. So all these contributing factor responsible for the causing the weight gain in a woman. Okay, so placental size is also increases, maybe there is two or maybe there is a one enlarged placenta. Okay, so by these all thing the woman's weight become more. Okay, now next talk about the cardiac output. So what will be happen with this? It will also increases. How? Because I already told you that woman is in a state of hypervolemia, that it means the woman's blood volume is increases during that period, and volume is increases, but in comparison to the RBC, RBC's count are not that much increases, just plasma volume is increasing more. So as the volume is increases more, the stroke volume will be more because more blood will be ejected from the ventricles, and as the stroke volume increases, the cardiac output will also increase. Because in simply you can say that there is a demand for the two fetus as well as the demand for the maternal need also. So all these contributes in the increasing the blood volume in a woman, because without that the demand could not be fulfilled. Okay, so cardiac output increases, but as I told you that RBC is not increasing, so in that condition woman may become anemic. So in this condition, the additional iron and folic acid is also required for a woman to compensate this deficiency. Now, the another changes which has taken place in a woman's body is the increased GFR rate. But obvious, the blood volume is increases, and by the effect of progesterone, blood vessels are dilating more. So there is a less resistance in the blood vessels because there is a decreased oncotic pressure inside the blood vessels. Why it is? Because there is effect of progesterone, and progesterone causes the smooth muscle relaxation. So the blood volume is increases and renal flow is higher with the least resistance by the oncotic pressure, the filtration rate will be also higher. So that's why the GFR rate is increases, and in a twin it is more in comparison to the singleton pregnancy. Now if we talk about the tidal volume, actually these all factors are increases during the pregnancy, but if we talk about the twin, then these all will be more and more and more and more. Okay, so tidal volume is also increases. So what it is? Tidal volume is the amount of volume of the air which we inhale or exhale in a one breath. So it is increasing. Why it is increasing? Because as the oxygen is consuming by a mother's body, because there is an increased metabolic need, and this oxygen is consumed by the fetus also, the oxygen in the tissues is decreases and the CO2 is more. And as the CO2 level is rises in the blood vessel, what is happening? There are some chemoreceptor which send signal toward the respiratory center in the brain, and once the signal sent there, what is happening? They insist mother to become more hyperventilate. So once she more hyperventilate, she will inhale more oxygen and exhale more CO2. Is that clear? So with the increasing tidal volume, वुमेन मे ब्रीथ डीपली. ओके, सो टू इनहेल मोर ऑक्सीजन एंड दैट ऑक्सीजन विल बी ट्रांसफर टू द मदर एज वेल एज द फीटस फॉर देयर नीड. सो ऑल दीज फोर फैक्टर्स इंक्रीजिंग मोर एंड मोर एंड मोर. वाई? Because there are the two fetus and their demand is higher. So weight is increasing more, cardiac output is also more, as well as more filtration rate, as well as the tidal volume is also increases in the multiple gestation. Okay. So now next we talk about the diagnostic features, how we can confirm the pregnancy. Okay. So before we diagnose, let's collect the history. And if there is any history of ovulation induction, or if any history of gonadotrophic use or ART, or if any history of hereditary, so it will confirm that by this only the woman is becoming with a twin pregnancy. Okay. So after history, we just need to collect the subjective symptoms from a woman. So by a subjective symptom, what woman may complain of? So woman may have the palpitation because heart is slightly shifted upward and outward because the height of the uterus is more. Okay, so as the heart shifted upward and outward, women may have palpitation as well as the shortness of breath, and with this gravid state of the uterus, the vein become compressed, and that can cause the varicosities as well as the edema over the leg. And also because there are the two placenta, or maybe because of the enlarged placenta, what is happening? One hormone is rising very abruptly. Which one? That is the HCG. So as the HCG level is more, what will be happening? The morning sickness will be more. Okay. So, but we can't confirm by this that woman is having more morning sickness than it will be multiple pregnancy, because there will be a variety of condition in which HCG level is rises. So we can't confirm. But what all subjective symptom would be there? Women may have palpitation, women may have shortness of breath, and she can feel more fetal movement around her abdomen, and also there will be a varicosities or edema over the leg. So there could be a subjective symptom we should collect before we go for the confirmatory test. Now before the confirmatory test, examiner must do the objective assessment. So by the objective assessment, examiner could found that there will be a increase in the symphysis fundal height. Why it is increasing? Because there are the two fetus, the as well as the amniotic fluid and the placental size, as well as the placental masses, the number of masses, that all help in the increase in the height of the fundus. So the height of the fundus, that is the SFH, the examiner which is finding, so SFH is more with the period of amenorrhea. So that could be found by the examiner, as well as the examiner could found many fetal body part by the palpation, and examiner also could found the fetal heart rate or fetal heart sound at a two distinct point with a variation of 10 to 15 beats per minute. And by inspection, one can see there is a cylindrical barrel shaped uterus. So the counter of the uterus is looking like a barrel shaped, okay, because there are the two fetuses. If we measure the abdominal girth, he will also found that is also increased, because there is increased fetal mass and the liquor amni as well as the placental sizes. So the girth of the abdomen around the umbilicus would be more than 100 centimeter at a term pregnancy. Okay, so that all thing will be the objective assessment the examiner could found. Now here is the confirmatory test, that is the sonography. Why it is confirmatory? Because by the sonography one can assess how many the placenta are there, how many fetuses are there, if they are viable inside or not, or if there any growth retardation is there or not. We can find out the placental location, is it in superior aspect or is it in lying in a low level, or we can find out that the lie and presentation of the fetus, because the commonest lie is the longitudinal and the presentation is the both vertex in 50% of condition, and in 30% condition the first fetus is in vertex and the second fetus in a bridge. So we can find out many of the things by the sonography, and we can estimate the exact week of gestation, because by the symphysis fundal height it is more, because we are getting more because of the two fetuses and the masses of the placenta. But by the sonography we can estimate the accurate week of gestation. And by the sonography, two important thing we can assess is that one is the chorionicity and the another is the amniocity. Chorionicity, in this we are measuring the number of chorions, chorionic membrane. So if there is dizygotic twin, in that condition what we can find out by the sonography, we can find out the twin peak sign or the lambda sign. So what is this sign? In this the chorionic tissues just invading inside the amnion. So it is look like a triangular projection. So as you can see in the figure, so there is a triangular projection of the chorionic tissue in between the amnion and from the base of this membrane. So this look like a lambda. So we are saying this the lambda sign or the twin peak sign. And once we find out this in the first trimester of the sonography, in the sonography we can confirm that this type of pregnancy is of dizygotic. And if there is an absence of this chorionic tissue in between the amnion and we are just seeing the two amnion line only from the base, it look like a T. So it is called the T sign. And once we find out the T sign, then it confirm the monochorion diamnion twin. Okay, so sonography is very essential to confirm the test. And if there is a conjoined twin, in that condition the MRI is a best test, because by the MRI we can exactly measure where these twins are joined together, and we can find out the exact blood vessels which anastomose between these two fetuses. So this is how we can confirm the twinning pregnancy. So firstly we need to take the history, the subjective symptoms, we can assess objectively what all things we can measure, but confirmatory test is a sonography. The biochemical tests are not confirmatory one, because as although there is a rise in the beta HCG level as well as the alpha fetoprotein level in the multiple gestation, but there are a variety of condition in which both these values are increases. So these are also increasing in this condition also, but we can not confirm by increasing this value that it is of twin pregnancy. So this was about the diagnosis of the multiple gestation as well as the maternal adaptation which is going to take place in a woman's body. So in the next part we'll discuss about the complication of the multiple gestations. Thank you.